Students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing well. So, it's time for SST class. Today we will start the new chapter in SST, that is chapter number 5 in Geography. So, students, in this chapter we discuss about the types of minerals and the various methods of mining, the distribution of mineral resources and their use, about the conservation of minerals, about the conventional and non-conventional power resources, and at last we discuss about the conservation of these power resources. So firstly, I want to tell you something about minerals. Minerals form a vital part of our day-to-day life. You will hardly find anything around that you does not contain any mineral in it, from the salt that you add in your food to the pen that you write with, the cream that you apply on your face, and the car that you ride in. Everything is made up of different kinds of minerals. Okay? So students, a naturally occurring substance that has a definite chemical composition is a mineral. It's called a mineral. Minerals and the power resources from the backbone of industry in any country. Minerals are used in everyday life, such as for construction, infrastructure and buildings, transportation network, as well as for industrial purpose. They are used in the production of steel, vehicles, computers, medicines, human and animal food stuff and fertilizers. So these are few names. The study of minerals are called mineralogy. What is it called? It is called mineralogy. So let me continue with the topic, that is mineral resources. Minerals are homogeneous, naturally occurring substance found in the earth's crust. They contain a single or a combination of different elements, different kinds of elements. They have definite chemical composition and physical properties. Minerals are constituents of rocks. All the rocks are composed of one or more minerals. In some rocks, large quantities of particular minerals are present. Such rocks are called ores. Okay? Students, minerals are extracted from ores. Ores are rocks having high concentration of particular minerals. The extraction of these minerals from the earth is known as mining. Okay? So let's move to another topic, that is types of minerals. Minerals have a wide range of color, hardness, texture and luster. They are identified on a basis of their physical and chemical properties. Minerals can be organic, inorganic or inorganic in origin. Organic minerals like coal and petroleum are such called mineral resources. Minerals like fuels or fossil fuels in the category of these organic minerals. Inorganic minerals are classified into two groups, metallic and non-metallic. Inmetallic minerals are those that contain metals such as iron, copper, aluminium, gold and silver. They are found as ores in igneous and metamorphic rocks. These minerals are hard, have luster and are generally good conductor of heat and electricity. They are further classified into two types, ferrous and non-ferrous. Ferrous metals contain iron, for example, manganese and chromite. Non-ferrous metals do not contain iron, for example, copper and gold. See here students, in non-metallic minerals, non-metallic minerals are those that do not contain metals. They include limestone, sulfur, potash, mica, gypsum. They are found in sedimentary rocks. These minerals are soft, do not have luster and are generally bad conductor of heat and electricity. So students, according to the para, there are over 3000 minerals. Minerals resources can be categorized into mainly two groups, metallic and non-metallic. Metallic minerals are the ones which have properties such as luster, solidity and hardness. Minerals like metallic minerals are extracted from the earth in raw state, known as mineral ore. Metallic minerals are further classified into two types, ferrous and non-ferrous. Ferrous minerals contain iron. Iron ore
Manganese and chromites are some of the examples. Non-ferrous minerals do not contain iron but contain some other metals. Examples are like gold, silver, copper, lead, etc. Okay? So let's move to another topic, students, that is mining. The extraction of mineral resources from the earth is called mining. The method of mining depends upon the depth at which the mineral is located. These are some of the common methods of mining. The first method is quarrying. This method is practiced when the minerals are located very close to the surface. And the next one is open pit mining. This method is practiced when the minerals are located at a shallow depth under the surface. They can be reached by just removing the surface layer. And then another one is shaft mining. This method is practiced when the minerals are located deep under the surface. They can be reached by digging. Deep holes are called shafts. Another one is drilling. This method is practiced for the extraction of minerals, oil from under the surface. It is done by digging deep wells called oil wells. See, students, according to our first topic, that is quarrying, according to our first topic, minerals are extracted from ores. Ores are rocks having high concentration of a particular mineral. The extraction of minerals from the earth is known as mining. There are three main types of mining depending on where and how a deposit is located. Minerals that are found just below the earth's surface are taken out by the method of quarrying. Okay? And another topic is open shaft mining, yani open pit mining. It is used to take out minerals that lie at the small depth, jo ki kam gehrai mein hote hain. Then next is shaft mining. Shaft mining is used for taking out the minerals that lie at great depth. The process of extraction oil and natural gas by boring deep wells in the earth is known as drilling. Okay? So, let's move to the another topic, students. Distribution of mineral resources. See here, distribution of mineral resources. Here a table has given to you. Table 5.1, uses and distribution of mineral resources. See here, mineral name was mentioned over here, iron, and the uses of iron, and another major producing countries in the world. Major producing states in India. See, students, according to this chart, the distribution of minerals are not uniform throughout the world. So here we are discuss about the distribution of these mineral resources. See, students, at least 60% of the world's known oil and natural gas deposits are found in Asia. Southern West Asia, especially the area around the Persian Gulf and Indonesia, Malaysia and Siberia produce large quantities of petroleum. Large reserves of coal are found in Siberia, China, India, Japan, Indonesia and Korea. Asia is the primary source of much of the world's tin and graphite. Tin is especially found in a belt running down the Malaya Peninsula to Indonesia. Iron ore is extracted in China, India and Siberia. Sri Lanka and Myanmar are famous for precious gems, and gold, nickel and platinum are found in Siberia. That is manganese, copper, bauxite as well as the phosphate and many other non-metallic minerals are also found here. So here, students, in the table, ये जो टेबल है 5.1 उसमें डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ लाइक यूजेस एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ मिनरल रिसोर्सेज ये सारे अवेलेबल है इसमें यूजेस ऑफ आयरन मैग्नीज कॉपर बॉक्साइट गोल्ड डायमंड माइका एंड लाइमस्टोन तो ये जो टेबल दी हुई है ये टेबल आप खुद पढ़ेंगे ओके सो लेट्स मूव टू द अनदर टॉपिक दैट इज कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मिनरल्स द इंक्रीजिंग वर्ल्ड population and the demand of more and more people to have higher standards of living have resulted in the increased use of mineral resources. Minerals are non-renewable. Once consumed, they have completely exhausted and cannot be regenerated soon. We have to use our mineral resources in a planned manner so that the future generation is not deprived of them. See students, minerals are non-renewable, exhaustible resources and need to be conserved. They need to be conserved because these resources, they took thousands of years for the formation and concentration of minerals. The rate of formation is much slower than the rate at which the humans consume these minerals. So that's why, moreover, wasteful use of minerals and power resources may lead to their exhaustion. So it is very much important for us that we have to conserve our resources. So see students, here the ways in which minerals can be conserved are, first is recycling. Many metals like iron, gold, silver and aluminium, once discarded, can be reduced by reused by recycling. See students, according to this topic, it is necessary to reduce wastage in the process of mining, and another, recycling of metals is another way in which the minerals can be conserved. Another is avoiding wastage. Efficient methods of mining and smelting can avoid wastage of minerals. While using them also, we should take care not to waste. And another is substitutes. Alternatives of minerals like biodegradable plastic, wood, other substitutes should be used more widely. See students, like researchers should also be carried on to develop new technologies which should avoid wastage and promote maximum utilization of byproducts. Like new explorations should be carried on to find out new location of minerals. An emphasis should be made on the sustainable mining. We should use those mineral resources which are renewable and are available in plenty. And we also use alternative energy resources. Energy is all around us, but the trick is harnessing it in a useful way. Whatever energy resource and technology we rely on, we can look forward to a clean, healthy and bright future. So that's why it is very much important that we need to conserve our resources. Okay students, so it's enough for today. Rest of the topic, that is power resources, we will continue in next video. So till then, enjoy your day and good day.